Hi everyone, Aaron here for Zolotech, and today the Android 11 August 2021 update is rolling out to supported Pixel devices and other devices as well. So if you have a Pixel 3, 3XL, 3A, 3A XL, Pixel 4, 4XL, 4A, 4A 5G, or Pixel 5, it's supported. Now it may be rolling out to other devices as well. It wasn't showing up yet on the S21 Ultra. When I checked, it didn't show. You'll see it's currently showing July's update, but hopefully it rolls out fairly soon, and we'll see it on those devices, but that's up to the manufacturer. Now, the overall size was 7.63 megabytes. That's on the Pixel 4XL that I'm using here. The Pixel 5 was about the same, and it's between 7 to 20 megabytes, depending on your device. So it's fairly small overall. Now let's take a look at the build number, and if we pull down here from the notification shade, we'll wait for it to roll back, you'll see it says 11RQ3A.210805.001.A1. And so this particular build, like I said, is fairly small, and I want to talk about the new features, and then we'll talk about the improvements and security as well. But before we talk about that, Google showed off the new Pixel 6 coming this fall. So you can see this is what it looks like. There'll be a 6 and 6 Pro with a new processor from Google, the Google Tensor, and it's their own custom chip. So this should be great for security as well as speed in the future. And you'll see the Pixel 6 Pro in different colors that we have here. I think it looks pretty nice. You've got this orange and then a green and then a black for both, and then a black, gray, and more of a silver slash yellow and gold color. I'm not sure. I'll have to see it in person, but it should be pretty great to check out this phone finally. There was a lot of rumored photos about it and different speculation, and they've officially announced it. They haven't given a price, but we do know it has a 120 hertz display with their own processor in it. So I can't wait to check that out later. Now, as far as the first new features and changes, if we press and hold on the home screen, go to styles and wallpapers, then go under curated culture, you'll see we have three new wallpaper at the top. And we'll tap on these, and you'll see they're to celebrate Australia's natural beauty. So the first one here, you'll see it's called Regenerate. So that's the first new one. The next one is called Waterways, and it gives a little explanation of what it is. And then there's another one as well that's called Elements. So these are all new, and again, celebrating Australia's beauty. So it's pretty nice that they keep adding these every month. We have a few different ones as well, so they add them for all of the different things throughout the month. So that's new in this update, or to everyone this month. Now, they've fixed an issue with the system UI. They've fixed it to prevent accidental triggering of Google Assistant. Now, specifically what they mean by that, whether that's swiping in from the side or squeezing the device, they haven't said, but it's for all supported Pixel devices from the 3 all the way to the 5. So that's the only thing they've actually fixed in this update. There's also additional security updates in here as well. There's quite a few, from everything from framework to media framework, system updates, Google Play system updates, kernel updates, Pixel updates for the NFC capability, so they patch security there, as well as MediaTek components, Widevine DRM, Qualcomm components, and Qualcomm closed source components. All of those have been updated with the August update. And so that brings me to, should you install this update? Well, if you haven't already, I would say absolutely every month you should install it, because they're important security updates. So most people install them pretty quickly if it shows up, but I would highly recommend it again for those security updates. Now, as far as overall performance, I would not expect performance to be affected in any way, since it's mostly just a security update and a small bug fix. So if you're having issues with that, I wouldn't really expect any issues there. And as far as battery life, I have not been using this 100% of the time. I've been using the Pixel 5 on Android 12 most of the time. And if we take a look here, you'll see the battery. It's just been turned on today, and then it was updated. So I charged it a little bit to install and then updated it. I would expect the exact same battery usage you had before. So that's it for the August update. It's a fairly small update, but it's nice to see those new wallpapers, and especially that new Pixel 6 that they announced today as well. Let me know if you've already installed it, if you have a Pixel device, or what device you're using, and maybe if you'd like to see me cover some of the Samsung One UI updates, I'd love to hear from you in the comments below. If you'd like to get your hands on this wallpaper, of course, I'll link it in the description like I normally do. And if you haven't subscribed already, please subscribe. And if you enjoyed the video, please give it a like. As always, thanks for watching. This is Aaron. I'll see you next time.